In this lesson, we are going to talk about the chlor-alkali industry. Now, the chlor-alkali industry is a real-life process that helps us to produce some important chemicals. Those three chemicals are going to be the following: chlorine, hydrogen, and sodium hydroxide. At the end of the lesson, I'll mention why we need those, but for now, we're going to try and see how we can find, or how we can make those. Okay, so the process starts by pumping in some brine over here. Now, Kevin, what is brine? Brine is concentrated sodium chloride. Concentrated sodium chloride. So NaCl. Now, we know that NaCl is going to actually dissolve or break up into its components, which is Na plus and Cl minus. Now, if we look at the charge on this battery, we can see that this is the positive terminal, which means that this electrode is positive. By the way, this electrode is made of titanium. That's not so important. I haven't really seen them test people on that. That's just for general knowledge. Due to the fact that this is a positive electrode, it will naturally attract the negative chlorine ions, and a reaction will take place. So what we do is we go find Cl minus on our table, and so the reaction is going to go like this. You're going to have 2 Cl minus turning into Cl2 plus 2 electrons. Kevin, why doesn't the reaction go the other way? Well, guys, it's very easy to remember. You're starting off with Cl minus, so it can only go to the left. You can't go from left to right, because we don't have any Cl2 to start off with. And so one of the products there is Cl2. Now, Cl2 is going to be gas, and so it's going to bubble off. And so you would see bubbles over here, and that would be your Cl2 gas. So there we go. We have produced our first product. Now, here's where it gets pretty interesting. This component here is a membrane. Oh, I should have mentioned that this is called a membrane cell. Now, this membrane is made of a material such as, it's almost like a polymer, and it's a very safe substance for the environment, and it has the ability to control what can go through this membrane. And for some strange reason, it only allows cations to go through. Cations are positive charges. And so this Na+, when it gets over here, it's going to be able to move through those little holes. And so the Na pluses are going to be able to go through. And so this compartment is now going to be filled with a whole lot of Na plus. Alright, now, in the chlor-alkali industry for this membrane cell, they also pump in pure water over here. Okay, so we've got pure water floating around, and we also have Na plus. Now, this electrode, which is now made of stainless steel, but you don't need to know that really, that's just general knowledge, is negative. And so naturally, it will attract the sodium ions. But can you guys remember way back when we were doing electrolysis, the introduction videos of electrolysis, we said that when water is present, it might be able to react. And so we always have to make sure about that. So what we're going to do is we're going to look for Na plus on our table. And then we said that the water that you need to look out for on the left is always this one here. I hope you guys can remember this. We looked at this in the very beginning stages of electrolysis. It was electrolysis in an aqueous solution. And so these two are going to compete with each other. And we said in that video way back when that the one that's lower down is going to win because it's got an increasing oxidizing ability. And so water is going to win. So water is going to be reduced. So the reaction is going to go from left to right. And so we're going to have 2H2O plus 2 electrons giving us hydrogen gas plus 2OH minus. And so look at this, guys. One of our second products is hydrogen gas. And so that hydrogen gas is going to bubble off because it's a gas. And so there is our second product. Okay, and so can you see that the other product in that reaction is OH minus? And so we're going to get a whole lot of OH minuses floating around as well. And guess what happens? Those NAs and those OHs, because they are oppositely attracted to each other, they'll form NaOH. And that NaOH will then flow out of here as our third product, which is sodium hydroxide. Kevin, would the OHs maybe flow through here? No, they wouldn't, because we said that this is a membrane, and this membrane only allows cations. It only allows the positive things to go through. So would the Na pluses maybe go back through there? No, they wouldn't, because this electrode is negative, and so that's what attracts the Na pluses from this side in the first place. Okay, so guys, that is how the chloralkali industry works. Now, why do we need the chloralkali industry? It is to produce Cl2, hydrogen gas, and NaOH. I'm going to give you guys two uses for each one, and you can just write these down and then use them in your exams. So chlorine, we use it to purify water as it kills bacteria. Okay, you know, if you have a swimming pool, you throw in some hydrochloric acid, which helps keeps your pool clean. They also use it for PVC piping. You know, like that white pipe that you get, for example, if you look outside your house, you've probably got a gutter for the rainwater, and that's made of a white PVC pipe, okay? PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride, okay? The chloride is Cl2. Hydrogen gas, pretty cool. They use this in rockets. So it's for rocket fuel. They also use it to produce hydrochloric acid. NaOH, we use it to make soap, and they also use it to make paper. If you guys want some more examples, then you can just go on to Google it. There will be so many answers. Your textbooks would probably have it as well. So there we go, guys. That's the chloralkali industry. Thanks for watching.